Всем привет! Сегодня мы в НАСА еще раз, и я пригласил моим друзьям, чтобы рассказать вам о этом задании и этот вертолет. Ну, сегодня это похоже на Марс атмосфера, и ну, я надеюсь, что это интересно для вас, и ну, надеюсь, что вам понравилось видео. Ставьте лайки и подписывайтесь на канал, и до следующего понедельника. До свидания.
Hello everyone, my name is Nathan Jensen. I'm a graduate student studying mechanical engineering at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, and right now I'm an intern here at NASA Ames. I do data analysis on this rudder system behind me and what's going on in the facility we're in. The facility is great for getting down to really low pressures, and when we're at those pressures, we need to measure what pressure we're at very accurately. You might have a barometer in your house that measures pressure at one atmosphere, or the air we're breathing right now, but when we get down to those tiny, tiny, tiny pressures, we need to know them very, very accurately. To do this, we have sensors called transducers. These transducers have a flexible membrane that deforms more when there's more pressure pushing on it, and deforms less when there's less pressure. We can measure that deformation and figure out the pressure to a very, very small margin. The other thing we need to know is the wind speed in this tunnel. When we pump down pressures to Martian densities, we're removing a lot of air from the facility. When that happens, we generate wind in this tunnel. And we don't want that. We only want to look at the wind generated by the rotor system. So we have to filter that out of the data and account for that. We measure wind speed with these L-shaped tubes you might be able to see right there. Those are called pitot tubes. You might see pitot tubes on airplanes, aircraft in general, and in other wind tunnels like this. These are only a couple of the many, many variables that we have to account for to understand how this rotor behaves in Martian atmosphere. That's my bit. Thanks.
Hello everyone. My name is Natalia Perez. I am an aerospace and mechanical engineer. I studied in Mexico in La Universidad Autónoma de Chihuahua, and I graduated from New Mexico State University. I am currently working with experimental testing being performed on this rotor. And there is something very unique about this facility, which allows us to test our rotor at Martian atmospheric densities, with the goal of being able to compare between experimental data and simulations, which in the future could help us to further develop and design planetary aerial vehicles.
How's it going, guys? My name is Chris Byron. I'm an intern here at NASA Ames this summer. I study mechanical engineering technology at the University of Maine, and today I'm going to show you a little bit about the test setup in the Marswood Tunnel. At the back here, we have a linear actuator that allows us to tilt the rotor disc. Right now, it's in its hover configuration. We can also tilt it more forward to simulate forward flight. Below, we have the motor that turns the rotor. Here we have three force sensors that allow us to measure force and moments of the rotor disc during testing. We have located at the rear, we have an RPM sensor that bounces a beam of light off a reflective piece of tape on the shaft, and that allows us to see the frequency at which it rotates. This silver piece on the shaft here allows us to mount another blade so we can test in two-bladed or four-bladed configurations.